I'm going to describe how to use an interactive simulation that models an autothermal reactor. There's another screencast that describes in more detail an autothermal reactor and goes through the balances to be able to model this system. Here, I'm going to concentrate on the interactive simulation. So on the right, I'm showing a representation of this reactor. So it's a tubular reactor. So the center, the blue circles are meant to represent catalyst. And then the annular region around the catalyst region or the active region is where the gas is fed. So this is the feed temperature of the gas coming into the reactor. The gas moves through the annular region. And then at this point, so the gas heats up because this is an exothermic reaction. So it enters at TF and is at a temperature T0. It then further heats up while also transferring heat to the feed gas and exit at some temperature, which is expected to be higher, of course, than the feed temperature. For the purposes of the model, we call this point at the beginning of the catalytic reaction our distance z equals zero, and then our distance is increasing to the right. So this is what we're modeling in this interactive simulation. And what we plot is this temperature is the temperature in the feed region. In other words, this region is the gas. No reaction is taking place. The gas is heating up so that it will react faster once it enters the catalytic region. So that's the red part. And then here, this temperature T0 is this temperature T0. And now, moving through the blue part, the blue temperature corresponds to the reactor temperature that you notice increases and then starts decreasing as reaction slows down and as heat transfer to the cold feed starts lowering the temperature. So this is what the simulation will show. What we're able to do in a simulation by using this slider, we can change the feed temperature, namely this temperature entering the annular region. We can also change the flow rate coming into the reactor, and we can change the reactor length. Of course, longer reactor, more reaction time, more preheat time. Now, in solving these equations, because we don't know T0, we don't know this temperature when we start to solve the differential equations and we solve them as an initial value problem, we guess this temperature T0, and if we get the right guess, then we solve these equations by increasing Z, we would get our correct feed temperature here. And so what the simulation allows you to do is change here to change this value of T0 to get the correct answer. So now I'll go to the simulation, which is whose location is here on the Wolfram site, and demonstrate how to use it. So here's the interactive simulation, and notice we're at a solution, so let's change this T0 value. So here now corresponds to where we have a feed temperature. We don't yet have a correct solution, and so we can adjust T0, and as we adjust T0, eventually we'll get to a T0 value that corresponds to the correct feed temperature for this condition, and I can fine tune that by stepping up or down to get more accurate there. So that's the correct solution. However, I could also pick a T0 that's much lower. That also is correct solution. It's not a very interesting solution because there's no reaction, but it satisfies all the differential equations. So understand there's multiple steady states possible for this type reactor, one of which there is essentially no conversion and one of which there is high conversion. Now we can change the feed temperature over a relatively narrow range and then change T0 to get, again, the correct solution. We can change the flow rate, and this is going to affect how much time for reaction. And so as we change the flow rate, it's going to affect what happens. So for example, at this low flow rate, now we have a solution, a very different T0 value. We can also change the reactor length. Okay, now I find a T0 that's a solution for this reactor length. The idea is you can change these variables to get a better physical understanding of the behavior of this autothermal reactor, where there's interaction between how much reaction takes place, how hot the feed is.